Most predators are opportunists. You know, they're kind of like bureaucrats. They just kind of wander around and pick off the easy stuff. That's why they don't go to Tyson's. They come to us, right?
I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost.
Inertia, and then we get up here and we can talk about things, but you gotta get away. You gotta start. So I'm Joel. I'll be your host for the next 2.5 hours. Welcome to Polyface Farm. We are certainly glad to have you here. And we did order up today's weather. Every day is like this here. It only rains at night. It only snows on the fields, not on the roads. You're like Camelot, you know, the leaves fall into neat little piles, you know. So it's a glorious day. We're real blessed to have the good day with us. We are in a field with a couple of thousand chickens. How's the smell?
Good.
Not bad.
Yeah.
Not bad. Yeah. So one of the things that we say is that good farming should be aesthetically and aromatically sensually romantic. If you have to put on a hazmat suit and walk through sheep dip to go visit your food, you might not want to eat it. We think that good farming and good food practices should be delectable to all of our senses. That's why God gave them to us, so we can tell what's good and what's. I mean, how do you know if a sore on your arm is infected? Smell. Yeah, you got a pus. Doesn't smell good, right? And so that's, you know, so I view, you know, stinky farms as basically just boils of pus on the landscape. And I think that it helps sometimes to use that kind of very visceral language to help us to punch through some of the, you know, it's all one big table, let's all get around and hug and sing kumbaya, you know, and it's all just wonderful. So this is the pastured broiler, which is a meat bird. In a minute, you'll also see layers today, but this is the pastured broiler, which these birds get moved every day. Can somebody come down while I talk and move a shelter, please? So we're out here in the field amidst all these birds. They get moved every single morning. And you can see the squares, what they've been. Yeah, this was yesterday, day before, day before, day before, day before. And you can go back, you know, about 7 days, and it's gone. So Eric, our apprentice manager, is going to move one of these shelters just to show you how we do it. It takes one person 60 seconds. You know, gone in 60 seconds. It takes one person 60 seconds to move one of these shelters. The birds just walk on the ground to the next spot. And so these guys are getting a treat. They're getting a double move today. You don't have to move it all the way, Eric. That's fine. That's fine. You get the idea. The birds just walk on the ground to the next spot. So they have vacated where they were yesterday. And they get this fresh salad bar every single day. It is that daily movement onto fresh ground, fresh pasture, that stimulates the ingestion of green material. It's the ingestion of the green material that is the secret for all the omega-3, omega-6 fatty acid, you know, profile balancing, the polyunsaturated fats, the riboflavin, and all of these vitamins and minerals, the color, the texture, everything is administered through the green material. So the whole idea is to get the birds onto as much green material as possible. Now, I think it's fascinating that that many of our customers who want good local food and have joined the, you know, the local food tsunami, this greeny, you know your farmer, know your food movement, also vote for politicians who pass legislation to protect the predators and put them on an endangered species list that make this very difficult. This is called intellectual schizophrenia. It's also called not knowing a clue about farming, which is why we try to get people out here to explain that, you know, when they're out down, when you drive Interstate 81 now and there's a red-tailed hawk on every other fence post, maybe they can come off the endangered species list. And so we, at the end of the day, we protect our stock, whether it's legal or illegal. We do whatever it takes to protect our animals so that we can eat and you can eat as well. And if we have to shoot, shovel, and shut up, that's what we do. But if young people can't get in, then the old people can't get out. And so both generations are stuck. And so one of the beauties of this, of the kind of infrastructure you're seeing here and what we call the portable farm, I want you to understand as we go throughout this tour, everything you're going to see is all portable. We can take this whole farm and put it on a trailer and head down the road with it. You say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up when I dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up.